SoundQubed presents how to make your own turntable for reconing subwoofers. First, you're going to need some supplies. Ready, set, go. Piece of MDF or plywood. Lazy Susan, not to be mistaken with my mother. Rubber feet, a piece of old surround or craft foam. Four low-profile half-inch screws and one one-inch screw. Measuring tape, razor blade, drill, and bits. A nail is the kind I use. A carpenter square will be handy. Sandpaper, pencil, jigsaw, long skinny scrap of wood, CA glue, box carpet. If you didn't catch all that, we put a supply list and tools in the description because we're just as sweet as can be. Now let's get to it. Take your piece of wood and mark the centers of the edges. Since I'm using a 4-inch Lazy Susan, I also mark 2 inches away from each center mark. Then, we go back to kindergarten and play a little connect the dots. Once you've drawn your guides, center up your Lazy Susan to make sure you got it right. Next, mark where you're going to put the screws that secure the Susan to the wood. I also trace the center, pretty much just for fun. Next, drill a hole where the center is marked. I just grabbed a bit that was about the size of the nail I picked out. If you're gonna use a router instead of a jigsaw to cut out the circle later, make sure the hole's the right size for your router's pin. I went ahead and drilled pilot holes for my screws as well. Next, we're gonna make us a makeshift compass. So grab that long skinny piece of wood and mark the center of it. Turn it 90 degrees and make a mark on the center line 1 inch away from the small edge. Then make a mark that's 5 inches away from the edge. We do this because we're making an 8-inch diameter turntable. If you want to make a different size, do the math. Next, drill a hole with the same bit you've been using at the 1-inch mark you made. Then, drill a hole at the 5-inch mark. Use a bit that's about the size of a pencil. Put the nail in the small hole and put the pencil in the big hole. Place a skinny board on top of the big board and make the nail go into the center hole you drilled earlier. Now hold it steady and spin it around. Congratulations, you just drew a circle. Now grab your jigsaw and cut out the circle. The edges are going to be pretty cattywampus, so sand them down for maximum baby bottom smoothness. If you're using plywood, really sand them down, or you'll be digging out splinters instead of doing recones. Next, grab your Lazy Susan and turn one side of it 45 degrees so you can get to the mountain holes. Grab your drill and screw that Susan down with the 4 screws I said you needed earlier. Give it a test spin. Wicked. It freaking works. Now grab that little piece of old surround or some craft foam. Weather stripping works too. Now very hazardously cut 4 small squares. Just kidding. Do it carefully. Now grab your turntable, flip it over, and give the corners of the Susan a light scuffing so the glue sticks on better. Put some glue on the little foam squares you cut out and stick them on the Susan. Once the glue's dry, flip it back over and grab your glue. Give the turntable a spin, slap away any distractions in the area, and then lay down your glue. You can also use contact adhesive on this part, but I was feeling lazy and didn't want to. You can use a little piece of surround or some foam to spread your glue out if you want. Next, grab your box carpet or whatever you like to cover the top of the turntable with and lay it down on the glue. Once the glue is dry, flip it over and trim away any excess. Next, act like a DJ and have a little fun. Stop! Fun time's over. Next, grab a rubber foot and the 1-inch screw from earlier. If you have a smaller sub, don't use a big foot or it won't fit in the motor's backside. Next, we're going to screw down the rubber foot. I couldn't feel the center hole through the carpet, so I poked the nail through. Then, screw down the rubber foot. After you screw in the rubber foot, you're all done. These turntables come in handy for cleaning frames before a recone and applying glue to a frame whenever you're doing a recone. Now don't forget to write your name on it in your best handwriting or someone might try to steal it from you. If you're wondering where to get a few of the things you need to make the turntable like this one, check out the description of this video where we provided some helpful links to some supplies. If you're curious about what doing a recone entails, check out our reconing video tutorial. Happy reconing. Y'all take care now.